Hello, today I will show you in details how to check a delegation rewards and payments from your baker by using BakingBad dashboard. When you open BakingBad's website and enter your delegation address, you get into the full-fledged dashboard for payouts audit. Let's name the columns in the main table. Cycle. As we know, Tezos timeline is divided into cycles. One cycle is approximately 3 days. So everything in Tezos happens in cycles, including earning and paying staking rewards. Baker's fee. It may vary from cycle to cycle because bakers can change their terms, hold special promotions, or just have a dynamic fee system. So pay attention to this column when checking earned rewards. Reward. This is how much you have earned from a particular cycle. This is the reward for the current cycle which is in progress. These are the rewards that earned but still frozen on the baker's account as a security deposit. These are rewards that are earned, unlocked, and can be withdrawn. If you see the hourglass icon, the payment is expected a little later, in accordance with baker's schedule. More on this later. Accordingly, if the payout amount is equal to the reward, then you see a green checkmark icon in this column. So, the last column indicates the total difference that the baker underpaid or overpaid, taking into account the whole history. It consists of local differences for each cycle. It's simple, how much is the baker had to pay, and how much he paid really. So, here you see a baker at the specific cycle with a link to this page on the Tezos Kitty Explorer. There you can find his contact info and then his configuration. In most cases, there are correct baker settings, and if you see a picture like this where everything is green, it's all good, man, and nothing to worry about. But to be confident that we have correct audit results, it is better to check some points. Baker's fee. This is the default fee that the baker offers to everyone. But if you have some individual agreement with your baker and your fee is different, just change it here. Minimum delegation amount. Don't delegate less than this amount, otherwise you won't receive any rewards. Next, we can see payout schedule settings. First, when does the baker pay? Tezos rewards that the baker receives accrued immediately after the end of the cycle, but they froze and become free to use only after 5 cycles. Accordingly, some bakers spend when getting them unfrozen, like here. Others pay in advance without a 5-cycle delay. There may be a third option like special prefers for some bakers. Second point, how frequently does the baker pay? Usually, there is no problem in paying on each cycle. Moreover, most bakers use tools for automatic payments. However, there are those who pay on their own schedule. There is nothing wrong with this if the baker does it in time as he stated. The baker score according to the schedule is reflected in the rating here. Values can be stable and unstable. If you see no data, then there are no public payments, or the baker is new and has a lack of payment history. Let's get back to the dashboard. Bakers in Tezos receive several types of rewards. For baking blocks, for confirming blocks, endorsing, transaction fees, and extra rewards or losses for the double baking, seed non-revelation, and other Tezos specific things. There are other subtypes of rewards, but it is for deep study. So, on BakingBad you can see which kinds of rewards your baker pays and which are not. Feel free to play with settings to understand how it works. Moreover, settings can be applied to all the cycles by default or only for specific cycles. Also, baker can charge transaction fees. In that case, payout amount is calculated as a sum of transaction amount and transaction fee. Reward tab. Here you can see the detailed information used to calculate the rewards of each cycle. Baker reward structure shows how much and for what he earned in the selected cycle. Delegator share is your share in the total baker stake. It also means how much of the baker rewards entitled to you. Payout tab. Here you can see the details of payments, when it is expected, how much, and so on. Also, here you can see how inbound transactions were mapped to specific cycles. For example, this one is a payment for this cycle. Then, we look at the table. Yeah, it matches. Great! Now let's move to the transactions page. Here you can find all the transactions that are linked to your account. You can switch off transactions which are definitely not a reward payout from your baker. For example, your personal income. This is recommended for more accurate matching transactions with cycles, so that it won't happen that your own transaction is recognized as a reward payout. The BakingBad matching algorithm is smart enough. and in most cases it automatically filters out excess transactions. But sometimes it makes mistakes, and here you can easily fix it. All changes and settings that you make are saved locally in your browser, which means next time you don't have to do it again. So you can also share your configuration using the share button, so your opponent can see exactly the same pictures as you see. Please don't be afraid to play with settings. Try to change everything to understand how it works and what you need it for. Only then you will realize the power and flexibility of baking bad dashboard. Don't be afraid to break something. You can always reset your settings to default values here. At the top, you will find a link to our chat where you can ask any questions, as well as a link to a page about us. Thank you for watching, and Tezos community is definitely awesome.